Now you talk about adjectives. In Portuguese, the adjective may come before or after the noun. Pessoa is Portuguese for person. So when you say good person, you can say pessoa boa or boa pessoa. Both forms are correct. Adjetivo uniforme. An adjective can be uniform when you use the same form for masculine and feminine situations. Example, simples. Um caso simples. Um simples caso. A simple case. Uma regra simples. Uma simples regra. A simple rule. Note that the adjective simples is the same for both masculine and feminine forms. Biform adjective. Adjetivo biform is the adjective that has a masculine form and a feminine form. Example, severo, severa. That means severe. Juiz severo, severo, juiz. Severe judge. Feminine form, juíza severa, severa, juíza. Severe judge. Another example, bom, boa. That means good. Sujeito bom, bom sujeito, good guy. Pessoa boa, boa pessoa, good person. Now the plural form. An adjective can have a plural form in Portuguese. Example, bons, boas. Plural form of good in Portuguese. Sujeitos bons, bons sujeitos, good guys. Pessoas boas, boas pessoas, good people. Until now, we have seen that adjective can vary in gender and number. There is also degree variation, and there are also other classifications, but we will not see that in this lesson, okay? Now an example with adjectives. O homem alto cantou uma bela canção. The tall man sang a beautiful song. O homem alto cantou uma bela canção. We have two adjectives. Alto, tall, and bela, beautiful. More examples. Smart, clever. In Portuguese, esperto. Feminine, esperta. Plural, espertos. Feminine plural, espertas. Smart girls, meninas espertas. Astute, astuto, astuta. Astutos, astutas. Astute boy, garoto astuto. Or menino astuto. Intelligent, inteligente. Inteligente, inteligentes, inteligentes. Intelligent man, homem inteligente. Good, bom, boa, bons, boas. Good man, homens bons. Bad, mal, má, maus, mas. Bad man, homem mau. Beautiful, bonito, bonita, bonitos, bonitas. Beautiful woman, mulher bonita. Tall, alto, alta, altos, altas. Tall man, homem alto. Expensive, caro, cara, caros, caras. Expensive clothes, roupas caras. Beautiful, another word for beautiful. Belo, bela, belos, belas. Beautiful eyes, olhos belos. That is it. I see you later. Now we are going to talk about the verbs ser and estar. In English, the most important copular verb is the verb to be. When you try to translate to be to Portuguese, you have two verbs, ser and estar. Ser is used when you are talking about essence or about a permanent quality. Example, ele é inteligente. He's intelligent. Estar is used when you are talking about a transitory state or a temporary quality. Example, ele está cansado. He's tired. Now let's see the conjugation of the verb ser in the present tense. Know that ser is an irregular verb. Eu sou, tu és, ele é, nós somos, vós sois, eles são. Eu sou, tu és, ele é, nós somos, vós sois, eles são. When you use você, it will be você é, vocês são. Remember that você is second person, but the conjugation follows the third person. Now the verb estar, that is also an irregular verb. Eu estou, tu estás, ele está. Nós estamos, vós estáis, eles estão. Eu estou, tu estás, ele está. Nós estamos, vós estáis, eles estão. Você está, vocês estão. Now some examples. Eles são honestos. They are honest. Ela é muito alta. She's very tall. Ele está sonolento. He's sleepy. Normalmente ele é calmo. Mas hoje está irritado. Usually he is calm, but today he is angry. The verbs ser and estar are not only copular verbs, they also have other functions. And now more examples with the verbs ser and estar. O crime é investigado pelo detetive. The crime is investigated by the detective. Ela está em casa. She's at home. Ele é do Brasil e hoje está na França. He is from Brazil and today he is in France. É noite. Eles estão chegando. It's night. They're coming. That's it. You are going to see the verbs ser and estar many other times, so don't worry too much for now. I see you later. Now we are going to talk a little more about pronunciation. We have already seen some of this before. In Portuguese, when a word ends in e, in everyday language, we commonly say i. And when a word ends in o, we commonly say u. So let's see the examples. Sabre, speaking fast, sabre, sabre, it means saber. Time, speaking fast, time, time, it means team. Lobo, speaking fast, lobo. lobo, it means wolf. Tempo, speaking fast, tempo, 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 it means time. Now let's talk about the A with the sinal, chill. A vowel with chill becomes a nasal vowel. So, A with the sinal means a nasal A. So we have maçã, maçã, it means apple. Fan, fan, it means fan. We also will find this nasal sound when a vowel is followed by M or N, M or N. Bambu, bambu, that means bamboo. Antes, antes, that means before. Now let's see A with chill plus O. Ão, ão. Pão, it means bread. We could expect that the pronunciation would be pan o, but in everyday language it becomes pão, pão. Another one, mão, it means hand. We could expect that the pronunciation would be mão, but it becomes mão, mão. Now let's see a vowel followed by L, L. So we have final, that means final, and animal, that means animal. We could expect a pronunciation like final and animal, but in everyday language it becomes final, animal. This pronunciation is typical from Brazil. In Portugal, they pronounce a little more the L sound. Now more examples. Airplane, in Portuguese, it is avião, avião. Action, ação, ação. Federal, federal, federal. Funnel, funil, funil. That's it. I see you later. Now you see some greetings and thanks. Cumprimentos e agradecimentos. Let's see some greetings. Oi, oi, it means hi. Olá, olá, it is similar to hello. Como você está? Como você está? It can be translated as how are you? Eu estou bem, obrigado. Eu estou bem, obrigado. I'm fine, thanks. Tudo bem? Tudo bem? It is similar to ok? Or is everything alright? E aí? E aí? It is an informal greeting. It is similar to what's up? Bom dia. Bom dia. It is similar to good day or good morning. Boa tarde. Boa tarde. Good afternoon. Boa noite. Boa noite. Good evening or good night. Tchau. Tchau. It is informal and comes from the Italian ciao. It means goodbye. Até logo. Até logo. It means see you soon. Até mais. Até mais. It means see you. Seja bem-vindo. Seja bem-vindo. Welcome. Obrigado. Or obrigada. Men say obrigado, women say obrigada. It means thank you. De nada. De nada. It is similar to you're welcome. It's nothing. Muito obrigado. Muito obrigado. Thank you very much. There's it. I see you later. Now you are going to see the months and the week in Portuguese. Meses e dias da semana. Let's see the months. Meses. I will say only in Portuguese, but I will say in order. Número 1, number 1, janeiro. Janeiro. Número 2, number 2, fevereiro. Fevereiro. Número 3, number 3, março. Março. Número 4, number 4, abril. Abril. Número 5, number 5, maio. Maio. Número 6, number 6, junho. Junho. Número 7, number 7, julho. Julho. Número 8, number 8, agosto. Agosto. Número 9, number 9, setembro. Setembro. Número 10, number 10, outubro. Outubro. Número 11, number 11, novembro. Novembro. Número 12, number 12, dezembro. Dezembro. Let's see the days of the week. Dias da semana. Domingo. Domingo. It means Sunday. Segunda-feira. Segunda-feira. Monday. Terça-feira. Terça-feira. Thursday. Quarta-feira. Quarta-feira. Wednesday. Quinta-feira. Quinta-feira, Thursday, sexta-feira, sexta-feira, Friday, sábado, sábado, Saturday. In everyday language, people will often omit this feira and say segunda, terça, quarta, quinta, sexta. Now some examples. Exemplos. Ela faz aniversário em março. Ela faz aniversário em março. She celebrates her birthday in March. O evento ocorreu em dezembro. O evento ocorreu em dezembro. The event occurred in December. Toda quinta-feira eles limpam o galpão. Toda quinta-feira eles limpam o galpão. Every Thursday they clean the shed. Hoje é domingo. Hoje é domingo. Today is Sunday. Now you are going to see the pronunciation of Q-U-E, Q-U-E, and Q-U-I, Q-U-I. Que, ue, que, ui, que. So, let's go. Ca, carro, car. Co, cor, color. Cu, curva, curve. But, ce, centavo, cent. CI, cigarro, cigarette. As we can see in Portuguese and at least sometimes in English, C, plus E N C plus E make the sound C, C, an S-like sound, S, S, C, C. But if you want the sound K, ki, 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 in Portuguese, how can you write that? Use Q, U, Q, U, Q, U, E, Q, Q, U, I, Q. Exemplos: queijo, queijo, it means cheese, quimera, quimera, chimera, quente, quente, hot, quieto, quieto, quiet, quieto, quiet. As you can see, in Portuguese, the U after the Q is not pronounced, but we have some words with Q, Q, U, where the U is pronounced. In other books, you can see this signal, trema, two dots over a letter, indicating that the U is pronounced. Frequente, tranquilo, consequência. Frequente, tranquilo, consequência. Today, the signal is abolished, so we have to know the words. But don't worry, you'll catch this with time. So, we have tranquilo, it means tranquil. In tranquilo, you do pronounce the U after the Q. Quieto, it means quiet. In quieto, you do not pronounce the U after the Q. Tranquilo, quieto. Now you see the Q-U-A, Q-U-A, and Q-U-O, Q-U-O. In this case, you will always pronounce the U after the Q. Exemplos: quadrado, quadrado, it means square. Quantidade, quantidade, it means quantity. Quociente, quociente, it means quotient. Aquoso, aquoso, it means aqueous. Now more examples. Quarto, quarta. Ela foi a quarta colocada. She was fourth. Quarta-feira é meu dia de folga. Eu vou limpar o quarto. Wednesday is my day off. I'm going to clean the room. Quinto, quinta. Eles estão na Quinta Avenida. They are on Fifth Avenue. Ele não gosta de quintas-feiras. He does not like Thursdays. That's it. I see you later. Now let's see the pronunciation of G-U-E, G, and G-U-I, G-I. Let's begin seeing a little more about the letter G in Portuguese. A letra G. G-A-G. Gasolina. Gasolina. Gasoline. G-O-G-O. Golf. 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 G-U-G-U. Gutural. 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 But G E G, gentil, gentil, gentle. G I G, ginásio, ginásio, gymnasium. As we saw in Portuguese, G plus E and G plus I create a G sound. G, 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 G. But if you want a G sound, G, G, how can you write that? You use G, U, E. G, U, E, G, G, U, I, G. Some examples. Geisha, geisha. It means geisha. Guiar, guiar. It means to guide. Salgueiro, salgueiro. It means willow tree. Guitarra, guitarra. It means guitar. Guitarra. As you can see, we do not pronounce the U. You just say gui, gui, guitarra. But in some cases, we pronounce the U. In all the books, you can see this signal, trema, 2 dots over a letter, indicating that the U is pronounced. Pinguim, ambiguidade, unguento. Today, the signal is abolished, so you have to know the words. But don't worry, you catch this with time. Pinguim, it means penguin. Ambiguidade, it means ambiguity. Unguento, it means unguent. So, G-U-E sometimes is G, sometimes is G-U-E. G-U-I sometimes is G, sometimes is G-U-I. Guitarra, we do not pronounce the U. Pinguim, we do pronounce the U. Now let's see the G-U-A and G-U-O. In this case, we always pronounce the U. So, G-U-A, G-U-A, G-U-O, G-U-O. Exemplos, guarda, guarda. It means guard. Ambíguo, ambíguo, it means ambiguous. And now let's finish with a short revision of examples. Gentil, gentil, it means gentle. Geisha, geisha, it means geisha. Unguento, unguento, it means unguent. Ginásio, ginásio, gymnasium. Guiar, guiar, to guide. Pinguim, pinguim, penguin. That is it. I see you later. Now let's improve our vocabulary. Vocabulário. But first, let's remember this. O is a masculine article that comes together with a masculine noun. A is a feminine article that comes together with a feminine noun. So, the article will help to identify if a word is masculine or feminine. First, I will say in Portuguese twice and then in English. O travesseiro, travesseiro, pillow. O cobertor, cobertor, blanket. A porta, porta, door. A janela, janela, window. A cadeira, cadeira, chair. A mesa, mesa, table. O substantivo, substantivo, noun. O adjetivo, adjetivo, adjective. O verbo, verbo, verb. A pronúncia, pronúncia, pronunciation. A letra, letra, letter. A palavra, palavra, word. O artigo, artigo, article. O pronome, pronome, pronoun. O advérbio, advérbio, adverb. O sujeito, sujeito, subject. O lápis, lápis, pencil. A caneta, caneta, pen. That is it. I see you later. Hi, now let's see the pronunciation of C cedilha. C cedilha. Cedilha is the sign. C with cedilha is the C cedilha. First, let's remember C and A, K, K. And now, C with cedilha and A, sa, sa. Sa, so, su. Sa, so, su. Let's remember that C and E is C and I is C. So there is no C cedilha before E and I. Some examples of words with C cedilha. Açoitar, açoitar, to flog. Laço, laço, tie, lariat. Maçã, maçã, apple. Açúcar, açúcar, sugar. Ação, ação, action. Nação, nação, nation. Ração, ração, ration. Operação, operação, operation. I want to make it clear, there are other letters that make the s sound in Portuguese. In this lesson, we are seeing C cedilha, like in ação, ação, action. C with E or I can also make the s sound, like centavo, centavo, cent. Naturally, S can make the sound of S, like in santo, santo, that means saint. Dois S's, the double S, can make the s sound too, like in assassino, assassino, assassin. X, that we call X, can make other sounds, but sometimes it can make the S sound, like in texto, texto, that means text. Texto, texto, it means text. Now, examples with C cedilha. Caçada, caçada, hunt. Começo, começo, beginning. Braço, braço, arm. Almoço, almoço, lanche. Doçura, doçura. Sweetness. And now let's revise this word. Caçada, caçada. C and A, K. C cedilha and A, sa. C cedilha and A, sa. Caçada, caçada. That's it. I see you later. Now let's see something about verb tenses, tempos verbais. Don't try to memorize everything. For now, don't worry. It's just an introduction. There are other moods, but in this lesson we will see only indicative mood. Presente, presente. In many cases, this verb tense is used to express usual actions or actions that are happening. It can, however, express other states. Some examples of presente. Eu falo português. Eu falo português. I speak Portuguese. Ele fala com ela todo dia. Ele fala com ela todo dia. He talks to her every day. Pretérito perfeito. Pretérito perfeito. Basically, this verb tense expresses a completed action in the past. Examples: Eu falei a verdade. Eu falei a verdade. I told the truth. Ele falou com ela ontem. Ele falou com ela ontem. He spoke to her yesterday. Pretérito imperfeito. Pretérito imperfeito. Among other things, it is used to express an habit in the past or the continuity of an action in the past. Some sentences with pretérito imperfeito. Eu falava mais quando era criança. Eu falava mais quando era criança. I talked more when I was a child. Ela falava sempre sobre esse lugar. Ela falava sempre sobre esse lugar. She always talked about this place. Pretérito mais que perfeito. Pretérito mais que perfeito. It expresses something that occurred before another event in the past. Eu já falara quando eles chegaram. Eu já falara quando eles chegaram. I had already spoken when they arrived. Ele esqueceu o que ela falara. Ele esqueceu o que ela falara. He forgot what she had said. Eu falara, ela falara. This verb tense is very little used in spoken language. In spoken language, it's more common people use a compound verb tense. Eu já tinha falado quando eles chegaram. Ele esqueceu o que ela tinha falado. Eu tinha falado, ela tinha falado. Futuro do presente. Futuro do presente. It expresses something that will happen in the future. Eu falarei a verdade. Eu falarei a verdade. I will speak the truth. Amanhã ela falará sobre a experiência. Amanhã ela falará sobre a experiência. Tomorrow she will talk about the experience. In spoken language, this verb tense is little used. In everyday language, people usually use verbo ir and infinitivo. Example: Eu vou falar a verdade. Amanhã ela vai falar sobre a experiência. Eu vou falar. Ela vai falar. Now another verb tense. Futuro do pretérito. Futuro do pretérito. It expresses something that would happen after something in the past. It can also express an hypothesis. Eu falaria sobre o que ocorreu, mas ela saiu. Eu falaria sobre o que ocorreu, mas ela saiu. I will talk about what happened, but she left. Ela compraria o presente, mas a loja estava fechada. Ela compraria o presente, mas a loja estava fechada. She would buy the gift, but the store was closed. Eu falaria. Ela compraria. It is used, but many times people speak it in other ways. Example: Verbo ir mais infinitivo. Eu ia falar sobre o que ocorreu, mas ela saiu. Ela ia comprar o presente, mas a loja estava fechada. Eu ia falar, ela ia comprar. Let's revise with the first person eu and the verb falar, that means to speak. Presente, eu falo, eu falo. Pretérito perfeito, eu falei, eu falei. Pretérito imperfeito, eu falava, eu falava. Pretérito mais que perfeito, eu falara, eu falara. Futuro do presente, eu falarei, eu falarei. Futuro do pretérito, eu falaria, eu falaria. And now just a note, it's about the conjugation of the third person, ele, ele. See the difference between pretérito mais que perfeito, falara, falara, and futuro do presente, falará, falará. Pretérito mais que perfeito, ele falara, ele falara. Futuro do presente, ele falará, ele falará. Don't worry about this now. We will see more about verbs in future lessons. This was just one more step. I see you later.